Hey guys, what's up? It's Patrick here, bringing you guys a brand new episode of my Clash of Clans Mailbag series. So once again, you guys can either drop a comment in the YouTube comment section below, or I'll throw all my social media links in the description. Ask me a question, whether it's Clash or something crazy, and if it's a good one, I'm going to go ahead and put it into the next video. So question number one, I've been getting this a lot, and that is, what do you think the next update will include, and when do you think it's coming out? So for a while, I was actually thinking the new update would be sometime in January, and on a live stream 2 days ago, someone actually dropped a comment in the chat that there was a post on Facebook saying that there was going to be sneak peek sometime soon. I'm going to throw that on the screen right now. That said on November 26th that they were planning on doing some sneak peeks, and that they were right around the corner, so it looks like we're actually going to have an update sometime in December. I was thinking it would be in January, because if you guys know, last year they were actually working on Clan Wars all throughout the winter, because that's when in Finland, where their HQ is, it's really dark, it's really cold, and that's pretty much when they get all their work done, whereas during summer it's bright outside and they take a lot of breaks. So I thought they were going to save up something gigantic for January, but it looks like they have something ready already for December. I don't know exactly what's going to be in it. Like I've said previously, I think they're focused more on feature related things, so instead of doing something like level 10 dragons or something crazy like that that costs 60 million gold, I think they're going to focus on something that is available to everyone. And by that, I mean maybe they're thinking of something that people have recommended for a long time, whether it's new single player maps, whether it's base designs, or maybe they thought of something crazy off the top of their head. I have no idea. And we'll just have to see what happens. And I'm hoping we get sneak peeks sometime soon. I'm guessing that they would be sometime early in December, but I don't know any date. They posted that a week ago, so maybe we'll get them within the next week or two. All right, question number two, Mike Gray asked, why don't we get all our troops back, or why don't we get back troops that survive 100% win in battle? So good question, and in the beginning, this might make a lot of sense that, hey, I want to get all my troops back, they didn't die, but if they made the game based around that, let's say I'm a Town Hall 10, and I went down to maybe gold, and I'm attacking Town Hall 7s or Town Hall 8s, for Town Hall 10, I could use a complete dragon army, I could use some sort of crazy go wipe army, and I could keep destroying Town Hall 7s and Town Hall 8s over and over and over and over. I would never lose any troops, I can pretty much destroy everything, and I would never have to wait to attack ever. And that would sort of be a little bit game breaking. I don't know if that's how they would want it designed, where higher level players could just attack lower level players and just constantly destroy them without having any sort of penalty for doing that. So I think that's exactly why they don't do it. Maybe there's some other reasons behind it, but that was the first thing I thought in my head. If you guys have any ideas why they don't do it, drop a comment, and let's go ahead and go to question number three. So Brandon asks, do you think there will be a button added to Clash so you can attack your own base to see if it's good or not? So this is another thing that's been ruled out, and I think this one's a little bit more obvious. So if you were able to attack your own base, let's say you get into a clan war, you're a Town Hall 9, and you're going to attack someone that's a Town Hall 9, and you don't know how to attack their base, all you have to do is redesign your base to match their base, and then you attack yourself, and you're going to know exactly how to attack. You're not going to know where the giant bombs are, you're not going to know where the Teslas are, you can make a good guess based on the gaps inside of that person's base, but it would make it way too easy to attack people in war, and it would be pretty easily exploited. Also, for top players who are known to attack each other a lot, especially the people in maybe the top 200 who see a lot of the same people all the time, they would be able to copy each other's bases and attack each other. I think that's a little bit less of an issue, but for clan wars, that would be pretty big, and I feel like people would really, really exploit that. So Jacob Cohen asked, any plans for Christmas? Special video, huge fan. Thanks for being a fan. As far as plans for Christmas goes, I have a good video idea, and also I did actually, this is the first video I'm recording in my new little temporary office, so I should be able to do a bunch more videos. I talked about that in the past, and I'm working on getting a permanent space, but I have a good idea for a special video, and that's all I'm going to say about that. I don't want to drop too many details about it, but you guys should see some cool stuff coming soon. All right, so Matthew Hackett asked, if you could go anywhere in the world with anyone, where would you go and who with? So if I could choose to go anywhere, I'd probably go to, I think, Tokyo, because Japan overall just seems like a really different place, and it has such like a different culture to it that it would be sort of crazy to walk around the streets and just check out Tokyo and all the different things they have going on there. Like, I've read articles, I've watched documentaries on it, but to be able to experience that in person would just be nuts. Like, it's one, I think it's the densest city in the world for population, even more dense than New York. There's just a crazy amount of people, there's so many different things than the United States, obviously. I feel like it would just be an awesome place to visit, as well as I did get the chance to meet the CEO of Sony Entertainment out at E3, and he was a really cool guy. He's actually a really big Clash fan, and he said he watched some of my videos, so maybe I'd actually be able to check out their headquarters when I'm out there and play some Clash. I think that would be really cool. So I think I would choose Tokyo, and as far as who I would go with, I'd probably just go with my best friends or something like that. All right, so final question. This was from Ivan's Clash of Clan on Twitter. He said, is Supercell support working on heroes' health bars to make them more visible? Hashtag ask Pat. So I think this is actually a really good question, and I don't know off the top of my head. I'll send a question to Jonas, who's one of the Clash of Clans developers, about this, because I know I have this problem sometime when I'm in the center of someone's base, and I'm sure you guys know how hectic it gets when you're attacking the town hall, and you have P.E.K.K.A.s there, you have your wizards there, witches, all the little skeletons, and there's just a ton of health bars, and you can't see your barbarian king or your archer queen, and before you know it, they die, and you can't really activate their ability, and that can be a huge pain. And I feel like a simple workaround to this, just off the top of my head, would be able to put the health bars on the actual icon. So when you drop your Barbarian King and your Archer Queen, there's a tiny little health bar on the bottom of their icon where you can see their health. So if you can't see it on the battle screen or on the battlefield, you can go ahead and look down to the bottom, and on their icon, it'll show you if they're low on health. Maybe it'll blink red or something like that and prompt you to push it. I feel like that would help out a lot, because there's been certain times in raids where things get like a little bit hectic. You can't really see the health bars, and you end up not being able to push their ability buttons. So that's my solution to that, and that's actually going to be the last question for this video. So once again, if you guys have any questions, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube comment section, Snapchat, MySpace, I don't know, ask wherever. I'll put the links in the description below, and I'll see you guys in the next mailbag video. Peace out.